Hello, my name is Laura, and this is my project, and it's a marble course. So the challenge of the project was to create a course that would allow the marble to go down, but some things needed to be done so that it wouldn't stop or that it wouldn't be too fast. So I had to add some obstacles, but I had to discover a way to let it go down without being too slow, but also having enough speed to go down the course. So my solution to this challenge was to put some obstacles, as you can see, the toothpicks, and also try to make the ramp with the least angle as possible that it runs down, and also but to have enough speed. That's why I put a little bit more of inclination over there in the top, and also on that ramp over there that gives the most speed. Some things that I learned in this project were that the surface texture really affects the outcome of how the marble rolls down. For example, my base was cardboard, and I thought that that wouldn't be a big deal because it wouldn't take off the speed of the marble so much. But it ended up that the cardboard I got, as you can see, has a little bit of bumps over there, and also the hot glue I put, I didn't know that if I left a little bit of excess on top, that would be a really big thing that would stop the marble from rolling over it. And that was probably the biggest problem. And some of my solutions that I tried were maybe like laying a piece of paper over it to see if it would smooth it out, but that didn't work. So I decided that I had to change the power I put when throwing the marble down. And that was is a pretty big factor for this marble course to work. So the result test that I ran, the marble goes down and it works, but it doesn't work all the time because we can't control exactly the same amount of power we put each time. So that means that since the course takes a lot of speed off the marble, especially the toothpick parts that was worked very well in taking off speed, we have to put a little bit more energy when throwing the ball in the first place.